Hello and welcome to the 17th part of my LEGO powered up tutorial that you can use to power up Control Plus and LEGO Boost. Today we will cover how to program a railway crossing. You can already see it in the image, and we programmed the train in the last part so that we can control it, but this time I want to program a railway crossing. And first you have to make sure that you know the pinout. In my case, the motors are on port A and B. The lamp for the light is on port D, and the sensor to see if a train is nearby is on port C. There's a small problem. Many of the cables are very short in the powered-up system, and there's no extension wire. So you have to look if this is really doable for you. Maybe you want to use a Control Plus motor instead of the simple medium motor that I use, because the Control Plus motors have longer cables, and the cable of the color and distance sensor from LEGO Boost is simply too short. Yeah, I use a color and distance sensor and I measure the distance to see if a train is in front of it. And now we can think about what a railway crossing does when a train approaches. We have lights that start to blink. We have a sound that gets played when the train is nearby. And at one point, the road will be blocked. So let's try to program that as well. And this will get pretty complicated in the end, but we will go step by step. And first, we want to discover if a train is nearby, and we can do that with the distance trigger. This triggers as soon as the distance value is below a certain value. In my case, it's 3. The color and distance sensor doesn't have a long distance that it can measure, so we have to place it pretty close to the railway crossing. I suggest that you place the color and distance sensor near a train station so that the train can stop, the hub can discover that, and then it can react and start blinking and stuff like that before the train starts again and wants to cross it. We can discover that a train arrives. And now we want to do a few things in parallel. We want to start blinking, and we want to make a noise so that cars know that the crossing will close. And we already have one path for the blinking, but we kind of need another path for the sound. And for that, we can use these two blocks. The blocks with the flag can trigger and can be triggered. This block or the start block will get triggered if this flag block is triggered, and they have to have the same ID. So the flag number 1 will trigger the start block with number 1. And make sure that you use the start block with the flag and not a normal start block. So now, if we reach this point, or if we are here, both this block and this block will be executed at the same time. There are a few things that you have to keep in mind when you do parallel stuff, and you should avoid that if you can, because you can't control one motor forwards and backwards at the same time. So parallel stuff can get confusing and can cause problems that you cannot find very fast. So I would suggest that you avoid parallel tasks as long as possible. Normally you can start a motor and then do other stuff while the motor runs, but in this case it wouldn't work because I want to have 3 parallel tasks, so we will do this. And the sound is pretty easy. We can simply create a loop and play the sound. I decided that sound 8 of the house is pretty good for that, or for a railway crossing, but you can look if you can find a better sound in the app. Next, we will discuss the train crossing. We want to trigger it as well when this one triggers, but we want to wait a bit before the gates close because the cars need a bit of time to realize that. So we want to program the gates, but first we want to wait a bit. And I prepared something. This is the control of the gates. It's pretty simple. I have two motors, so I have the motor on port A and B, and both run at the same time. And first I wait before I start the motors so that people can go away from the crossing. Then the gates will close if I drive the motors forward for 1/10 of a second. Then I will stop the motors. I will wait 5 seconds for the train to pass. Then I will start the motors into the other direction so that it opens again. I will drive them for a longer time because they have to work against the gravity, and then I will stop them again. You can also try to go to a certain position with this or this block if your motors have position sensors, but mine don't have some, so I will use the motor or the dump blocks. Only the light is missing, and we want the light to get brighter and then to get darker again, so we will have to use a variable. I will use the first one, alpha, and then we want to repeat that because the lamps don't get bright and get dark and then the gates open again, but it will blink a bit. So I will repeat that a few times. I tried it, and 5 times works pretty well in conjunction with the train closing. You will have to adjust the times of the blinking if you adjust this wait block. And now I want to add one to the variable until it's at the maximum of 100. So we can repeat that. And this loop repeats the stuff that is in the loop as long as the input here is true. So we will have to check if the variable is below 99 or 100. And as long as it's below 99, it will repeat the stuff in this loop. I can use the variable here. And we want to set the light of the LEDs to the value of the variables. And we want to add something to the variables. Now you can add one, but then the light will blink very slow. Or you can add a higher number for the light to blink faster. I will use 5 because I think that the speed is pretty good, but you can, as always, try it on your own and use your own value. Now we can get back to dark, and I prepared something for that. It's pretty much the same, just that I subtract 5 from the variable. Here I add 5, here I subtract 5. And you check if the value is above 1 and not below 99. That are the two differences for the part that gets darker. And if it's ready, we can turn the lights off. So we can set the brightness to 0%, and we can stop the other programs. Now you might ask why I do that, or why we do that. This ring will be in an endless loop, so it will ring forever as soon as this gets executed once. But we want it to ring until the gates are open again, or until the light stops blinking. So we can use this block to stop other parallel tasks. We can use it to stop this path and this path. This path will be finished before I start this block or before we get to this block, so we don't have to care about this path. You might have to do that if you adjust the program, but this will run indefinitely, and we don't want that, so we will have to stop it with this block. There's also another stop block, but we might discuss the differences in the future. Let's try it out. I selected the wrong port for the trigger because the color distance sensor is on port C. But now we can try it out. I can control the train with another device. Well, I drove a bit too far because I wanted to stop at the station. But now we can start again. So let's drive again to the station. It seems that one of my gates doesn't work properly. People entered the train and left the train, and now we can start again. We can drive a bit around, and now we can go back to the station, stop there, wait for the crossing to get down, and repeat. You could also try to make the duration that you wait dependent on the color and distance sensor, or you can make that longer for the people to have enough time to enter and leave the train, but that's up to you. Also, I think that this part was pretty complicated, so please feel free to ask me any questions that you've got in the comments. I would be happy to answer them. Thanks for watching this part. See you in the next part, and bye.